Consciousness is something that has confused humans since the beginning of our existence. It is very real to all of us, and the idea of us not existing messes with our minds. It helps act as an anti-suicide mechanism, and through mirror neurons allows us to not only be self-aware, but realize that other people are as well. The sense of self probably evolved as a way to ensure self-preservation beyond animal instincts. Most animals aren't suicidal. The survival instinct is too strong. With the ability to reason was the necessary need to up the survival instinct with something else. Also, with mirror neurons, it helped preventing you or thinking twice about killing someone because they also were conscious. The brain doesn't deal with the death of others very well, but if the brain evolves ways to think that the person has part of them that lives on, it will help prevent things like suicide. The ability to imagine has a lot to do with this, as we can hold the image and emotions and essence of a person in our mind, even when they aren't there, though it's actually our perception of them because we can't read their mind. So the brain gives us weird sensations, all of which can be replicated in a lab, making us think there is a presence or a soul even when there is none. Consciousness is where the idea of the soul and spirit came from. Archaeologists find that things like ritual, art, and burial are indications of belief in a soul, which date the idea of the soul back to at least 200,000 years ago. The ever-present awareness of self has led to many of the major religions, some believing the conscious to be immortal, just living in different bodies, and some believing your soul is immortal and will be rewarded or punished after your body dies. Your brain is made up of multiple components, reptilian and animal brain, as well as the neocortex, though they all can be further segmented, of course. The neocortex is the closest part of you that could be considered to have free will. You have about as much control over the other parts of your brain as you have control over your cats. You may own them, but you don't control them. There is a constant struggle between the neocortex and the animal brains, and if the neocortex is not educated or strengthened enough, it will lose more often. However, the brain has a way of rationalizing why you did something after the fact, because it can cause cognitive dissonance. You will incorporate these rationalizations into your memory of the event, and since you rewrite your memory every time you access it, you will believe you did what you did consciously and by choice. Neurologists have said that humans don't have free will, but what they do have is free won't. The neocortex can stop the animal brain from doing something, just like you can stop your cats, but it is difficult and you have to know the right tricks for the human brain to make the animal brain do something. Just like knowing the tricks for animal training, it's really hard to make your animal do something it doesn't really want to do. Emergence is a property where the whole becomes greater than the sum of the parts. Each piece of, say, a car on its own, while it may serve a function, now becomes something much more than itself. Mathematics has shown that not only does order continually move toward chaos, which is a property we define, not nature, but also that order is constantly springing from chaos. Jared Diamond's book, The Third Chimpanzee, points out that every attribute we think of as human shows up in some form of animal, especially social ones. Our brain and enlarged neocortex just allowed all of these mental evolutionary adaptations to reach a point to which the whole became much greater than all of the parts. This is called consciousness, and what neuroscience is delving quite strongly into at the moment, and hopes to have the brain completely mapped by around 2020 to 2025 as soon as our computers are fast enough. Ignorance of what scientists have discovered continues to lead to old and logical-sounding arguments for the religious. There are three ways to explain consciousness. 1. It resulted from the random forces of nature. 2. It simply exists. And 3. It was caused by another self-existent consciousness. Of course, God. The problem is that there are several logical fallacies involved. 1 is actually a straw man statement. Although I doubt many conservative religious has looked into the science of both evolution or the properties of emergence. Nature is hardly a random force. The universe follows many complex laws that are inherent to the universe. Physicists are postulating that it's possible that alternative universes have other laws they follow, but that's speculation at this point. These laws exist. There are random mutations, but natural selection is specific to the ecosystem and environmental pressures, which are constantly changing. Understanding chaos theory was actually the last linchpin I needed to lose my faith. Part 2, It Simply Exists, is believed by many in the East, and consciousness has always existed. Of course, our personalities are dependent upon the hardware of our white and gray matter. A person who has brain damage ends up with completely different personality. You now have a completely different view of life, different temperament, and sometimes different beliefs. We are all on brain drugs, each with a different cocktail. We are dependent on our biological hardware for our consciousness. So, if there is a soul, it really has little evidence for affecting the next body you inhabit, as temperament, emotions, and knowledge are linked to the composition of the brain. Though, it's easy to find patterns in places where they didn't exist, and if you know someone with a similar temperament, look, or essence, that the assumption that they were reincarnated from a dead relative would not be a far leap in our minds. Of course, that goes to the point that an Asian man thought his dead wife was reincarnated as an elephant at the zoo and was caught engaging in marriage-like behavior with it. Yeah, he was sent to prison for it. Part 3 of It Was Caused by Another Self-Existent Consciousness, or God, is what is called special pleading in terms of science and logical fallacies. God is a very complex organism and doesn't have to be created. But we did? That's giving God a special treatment and is highly improbable, especially without any evidence. Emergence is actually much more probable than a highly complex being popping out of nowhere, having always existed. You might as well just say fairies or wizards did it. You have equal amount of evidence. Zarkov 45 points out that while the religious are currently, for the most part, ignorant on brain science, they will soon probably wage war on neuroscience even more viciously than evolution. It is one of the last God of the Gaps arguments, and if a soul doesn't exist, then almost all religions and versions of spirituality don't exist. The concept of going to heaven won't work as well without the body and brain. Also, with neural implants, life extension, and backing up one's brain on a computer, the idea of a soul in heaven will face its greatest challenge yet. Unless they just say that heaven is a computer that allows your brain memory to exist and interact until your body resurrects. They will resist it until it becomes so overwhelmingly evident, then change their religion to make it fit the new science, or, of course, ignore the massive contradictions between the two.